When I go to nursing homes, I really don't like to do sad songs or cheating songs. That's what the, you know, I don't like to do cheating songs so much because a lot of those people in the nursing homes have lived life already and have been cheated on or cheated somebody else and just probably regret it. So I try to keep those songs to a minimum. But here's a song that I really, really like doing. Flatt & Scruggs did it. I don't know who the original artist was, but I know that New Riders of the Purple Sage had a hit with it, oddly enough, like in early 70s, I want to say. What year is this? Right now, we're in the 2020s, right? So if you go back to the 70s, it's at least 50 years the song's been being done. Well, you go back to the Flatt & Scruggs, that was the 40s and 50s. Holy cow. Anyway, it's a good song. It's called Dim Lights and Thick Smoke and Loud, Loud Music. Key of D, my favorite key to sing in. Have you figured out your favorite key yet? So there's a delta in it, a golf, and an alpha. It's an easy three-chord song, my friends. So maybe you put this in your repertoire that you can play when you go into call the activities director at the nursing home or rest home or whatever you have near you. Once you get 10, 15, maybe even 20 songs, you probably won't do all 20. But it's nice to have them because sometimes people say, "You know anything by Hank Sr.?" And then you've got one, all right? Here we go, Dim Lights, Thick Smoke. Get your note. Dim lights, thick smoke, and loud, loud music is the only kind of life you'll ever understand. Dim lights, thick smoke, loud, loud music. You'll never make a wife to a home-loving man. A home and little children mean nothing to you. A house filled with love or a husband that's true. You'd rather have a drink with the first guy you meet, and the only home you know is that club down the street. Dim lights, thick smoke, and loud, loud music. It's the only kind of life you'll ever understand. Dim lights, thick smoke, and loud, loud music. You'll never make a wife to a home-loving man. Drinking and a dancing to a honky tonk band. When you left your loving family, that's right back where you ran. So go on and have your fun, but you won't always look so smart. When the day comes, that lonely barroom breaks your honky-tonk heart. Dim lights,
thick smoke, loud, loud music. It's the only kind of life you'll ever understand. Dim lights, thick smoke, loud, loud music. You'll never make a wife to a home-loving man. You'll never make a wife to a home-loving man.
I think I was married to that woman once. Glad that's over. I wanted to remind you that a really great trick is to practice your chords in the dark. That way, like what I'm doing right now is I'm watching the camera, I'm watching the monitor, I'm reading music, I'm playing the guitar, I'm mindful of where my microphone is. I really can't be paying attention to where my fingers are going. Right? So my fingers just have to know where they're going. And I told you this. I was maybe 10 or 11 years old. And I was having a hard time getting the hang of the guitar. I'd played drums up to that point in my Cajun family's band. But I wanted to play a stringed instrument. So I picked up the guitar on my own and just started forcing myself to learn. And, man, I was doing that thing where first string, second fret, string one, string, finger two on string. And, man, it was awful. Because I'd seen my family, my cousins, my uncles, even my dad and my mom play as well. And they would just go, well, how do you do that? Well, just practice, son. Well, I practiced, and it was awful. So what I did is I said, you know what? I'm going to play by listening to what I'm doing. And if you... something's wrong, you just move your fingers around until they're right. And so I remember I was living in Tucson, Arizona, 10 years old, I believe, and I turned out the lights and I laid down on my bed and held that guitar. And I said, I'm going to get to where I can play the... And it didn't take long. I bet just one or two nights of struggling with it. And I got it. And you can do the same thing. So practice in the dark. The other thing is practice every day. Practicing every day for a couple of minutes, 2 minutes max, or 2 minutes minimum. Because sometimes you'll play five, sometimes you'll play seven, sometimes you just play two. But commit to 2 minutes a day. And what that does is that keeps the neuro networks in your brain fresh. If 2 minutes a day is better than 25 minutes or an hour on the weekend, okay? And the other thing is leave your guitar in a stand next to your easy chair. That way, whenever you sit down for the evening, you can just reach right over and pick it up and put it in your lap and play a little bit. Play quietly maybe during the movie or when commercials come on, mute them and then just practice. And you'll see a world of difference. You're not that far from it. If you're struggling trying to remember where your chords are and getting your fingers into the right place, if you're already holding a guitar and trying to do it, you're not that far from being able to do that bit. Okay, please hit like and subscribe, and leave a comment, and I'll try to respond to you. I see all the comments, I believe, and I try to respond to each one.